The ultrafast electron microscope brings together two separate techniques, both of which are very complex in their own right. One of them is ultrafast laser spectroscopy, and the other is transmission electron microscopy. So we use the ultrafast lasers to excite and create ultrafast electron pulses. And because electrons have a smaller wavelength than the light that we can see with our eyes, we're able to see nanoscale materials in the transmission electron microscope. The UEM is a unique tool because it provides us the ability to observe non-equilibrium dynamics, and then we can measure those atom-atom and electron-electron interactions using various detectors in the UEM. One of the ways is direct imaging with the electrons, like a transmission electron microscope. Another way is electron diffraction, where we can get information about the crystallinity and other components of a material. And the third way is spectroscopy. So all areas of nanoscience and material science can benefit from the UEM. One big area of research is phonons, and those are important for things such as cell phones, solar panels, batteries, and other energy storage materials. They're also very important for quantum information sciences. Another thing that we can do is observe photon-electron interactions, and this is important for the fields of nanophotonics and biomedical applications. Other areas are looking at charge density wave physics, looking at magnetic materials, and even an emerging area is soft materials. So polymers, such as those we use for upcycling and the circular economy, as well as biological materials for biomedical and bioengineering applications. We also share a beamline, the hard X-ray nanoprobe, with the advanced photon source. And after the advanced photon source upgrade, we will also be doing ultrafast dynamics with our hard X-ray nanoprobe. So the ultrafast electron microscope just expands our suite of ultrafast photons, ultrafast electrons, and ultrafast X-rays to be able to study the dynamics of a wide range of materials, and that spans the different time and nanoscales.